He humiliated Vladimir Putin and now has paid the ultimate price. Mercenary leader Yevgeny Prigozhin, who led the failed mutiny in Russia, is now dead and his private army is in disarray after a suspicious plane crash killed its top commanders. Here's our Europe correspondent, John Paul Gonzo.
The final moments of a feared warlord's life. Yevgeny Prigozhin's private plane plummets from the sky, crashing, then exploding in a field between St. Petersburg and Moscow. Russia's aviation authority claims the mercenary leader was on board along with nine others who all died, including Wagner commander and co-founder Dmitry Utkin.
I don't know for a fact what happened, but I'm not surprised. There's not much that happens when Russia is not behind.
The cause of the crash is unclear, but some reports suggest the plane was shot down by Russia's air defence systems.
But because this is such a high-profile event, there is no chance at all that we'll ever get the true story.
In June, Yevgeny Prigozhin mounted the most serious challenge to Vladimir Putin's authority since he came to power. Wagner troops led an armed rebellion, seizing military headquarters in southern Russia before threatening to march on Moscow. The mutiny was short-lived. Putin was humiliated and Prigozhin was exiled from Russia.
He might have lulled himself into this false sense of security. Maybe he thought that he was going to survive this.
But analysts say Prigozhin was a dead man walking and predicted he would eventually pay the price for his betrayal of President Putin, who was once a close ally. Wagner soldiers are still active around the world, including in Africa, where the last known video of Prigozhin was believed to be filmed.
I think there will be a very serious question of where the loyalty of those troops lie. Whether it's to Prigozhin and in resenting the Russian state for killing him, or whether that loyalty can be won back to Moscow.
If this was an act of Kremlin karma, Vladimir Putin has ignited an angry mob who have vowed to avenge the death of their leader, potentially destabilizing Russia again. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.